in. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up you guys? It's Kref Farms here with another video. I just want to start this video off by saying thank you for 1,481 subscribers. We are 19 subscribers away from the 1,500 subscriber Q&A video. I also want to say sorry for the lack of videos lately. As I said in a previous video, I had been working at Black Powder Fireworks, and that was... I was gone. I wasn't staying at home most of the time. I didn't take my laptop with me, so didn't get around to making videos, but now we're going to get back into the swing of things. I'm recording this on Thursday, but I'm going to put it up tomorrow, Friday, and just to make up for, you know, videos not being up, and then I'm going to have a video for Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, and they're all going to go out at 2:30 Central Time. They're earlier, but they're not noon. Or tomorrow, you know, this video you'll be seeing at 4 o'clock Central Standard Time on Friday, and then Saturday and Sunday's videos will go up at noon. That's how we're gonna work that. So the Belgique Profonte save game got messed up, and I can't save it. To get it back. So we're going to be playing on a different map. So I'm going to go ahead and set the timer here, and we're going to get started. This is Dad's Farm 2015 V2. So we're going to hop on in here, and I'm going to start off by turning down my game volume. Turn that off, that off, that off. There. All right, so now I'm also going to turn my map off. And soil mod off, as well as the HUD. So this is a fairly decent sized map. I'm not sure exactly what size it is scale wise. I'm wondering if this isn't... No, this is probably only a 2x. A 4x would be a lot bigger. I don't know what size this is, but it's a very nice sized map. So we're going to go ahead and I'm going to show you guys around the farm, and then we're going to get started on some work. So we're going to walk in, can't go in that door. Okay, so we'll go in this door here. In here we have a John Deere 9620R with the John Deere 2730 combination ripper. And then we have another 9620R with a John Deere 2623 disc. And then here, we're just going to tab through everything. So here is the GMC 3500 Sierra, and then this is that. Okay, and then this is the John Deere 8370R hooked to the DB120. Here we have the Rogator 1386 spreader and sprayer. These are from American Eagle's Modding. A pack was just released. There's a whole bunch of them in there. I will show you guys. There's the spreader. It comes in standard wheels and floater wheels, as well as the sprayer. And then you can also widen the wheels out with mouse controls. And then... if we go ahead and shut this door. So then here we have another 9620R. This is a really nice looking tractor, and figured I'd use a few of them. Hooked to the John Deere Flex Wing Air Seater Pack. Then we have the LR85 hooked to the KSIH Quad Track 500 ATI US. And then we have a 620 ATI US. This is another new pack from American Eagle's Modding. There's been quite a few releases in the past few days on American Eagle's Modding, which has been really cool. Here we have the Case IH 5310 applicator. This is not the side dress version. And then we have two tanks hooked behind that. That's right. I need to update my version of this trailer. Because if you look, right here it has a rigid body. Really, I don't have to download a new version. All I gotta do is... Well... I don't remember if he made some changes or not, but yeah, so Then we have two Freightliner FLD-120s. One is hooked to the Wilson hopper trailer, and the other is hooked to Random Sparks Media's tender trailer, which, you know, has the rigid body issue. So then here we have the Can-Am ATV. And then in this shed, we have the Lexion 770, the Kinsey 1300 grain cart. We have the Cote, I think is how you say that, Garant, and Cote Universal trailers for Slurry. And then we have the Huel, I think is how you say that. The Huel, that's what I'm going to say, 6100 that Sirius Mods had released. The Versatile 535 from BC Bueller Modding. Joe Lindbergh's T9450 Realtree ATI. And then two JCB Fast Track. I think these are like 3810s or something. 8310s. Okay, I was close. So I just want to get everything to in-cab view. Alright, and then I also have a Slurry purchase point right there. So what we're going to be doing in this episode, since all but one field, all but one field is grown, or is already harvested and in stubble, a couple of them, you know, like that field, they already have manure stuff on them, but what we're going to do is we are going to take the Versatile 535 and Huel spreader, and the Cote equipment, and we are going to start spreading some slurry on all the fields that don't already have stuff on them. We're gonna get our weights and duels back on here. So then we will fill this up to begin with. And then and we're going to get these things. Wow, it's really laggy in this yard. That's what I get for buying a bunch of equipment, I guess. But yeah, I hope everybody had a good 4th of July. I sure did. I was working most of the evening on the 4th, but I did... did have some fun. My dad and a cousin of mine and a bunch of other people were there, and we lit off a bunch of fireworks. We actually went and bought more fireworks as we were and before we had finished lighting them all off. It was kind of funny. We said, me and my cousin said, we want to go to we asked my papa, can we use your car and go to Memory Fireworks and go buy some more fireworks? And he's like, well, don't you have enough? Nope, can never have too many fireworks. Never can have enough, is what we said. So, oops. There we go, there's the refill point. And I don't know if this trailer will refill from a trigger or not. I don't think you can, but we're going to find out. Oops, I'm way too close. So yeah, today's actually like the first time I've played Farm Sim in quite a while. Not just because of work, but just in general. I have hardly played. That's making a weird sound. Just kind of been bored with the game, but decided I'd play some more. This map does have beef on it as well, and we might get into that later on. But for the time, I'm just going to stick to the crops, and then later on, maybe I'll get into them, but not at the moment. Let's see if I can refill this here. No, I cannot. I did not think so. Alright, so we will get this guy on Follow Me mod as well, and then we will head on over to the field. So, I think we'll head on over to field maybe 12 or 13, let's see. 11 here is already spread. Oh, I guess we'll go right here to field 14. Come on, quit being so laggy. I think the fact that I'm recording also is not helping that, because I know it drops some frames when I'm recording, but I didn't think it was this bad. So I'm going to drop this right here. And then we'll pull this guy up beside it, and we'll fill it on up. Start overloading. I'm not sure. I have to look how much this holds. 55,000, and this trailer holds 30,000. Okay, well, we're going to go ahead and we're going to get started on spreading. Alright, let's get this brought up, get our width set, shift our course over a little bit, and we'll back on up, and get lined up. Whoa, I have a ginormous offset that I do not want. What? No. Dismiss. I don't want to hire a worker. What the heck? I'm going to get rid of my offset. There we go. Now we're talking. Alright, so let's get a screenshot here. Yeah, this is like the first time I've done slurry in forever. I have hardly ever done it. Just normally I don't have a use for slurry. There's always a use for it, but never have it. And that's just, you know, because normally I don't do animals. But just recently I got that purchasable slurry point. Or the placeable slurry purchase point, whatever the heck you call it. And now I can use slurry and have it more readily available. My cruise control is set pretty low. So we'll set that down to about 10. There we go. That's better. Yeah, this map has a wide variety of field sizes. There's some large, some small, which is nice. It also has soybeans on it, which are also nice. I might go in and edit it so that it has sunflowers as well. Maybe I'll use this map to try and figure out some crops. Since this map already has soybeans, I can't really mess with that, but I can mess with oats and sorghum and try and get those figured out. I already know how to do sunflowers. That's the only one that I really know how to do right now. So, So we're fertilizing the grass as well, I guess. Oh well, what can you do, I guess? yeah, so just want to give you guys a little bit of an update on mods as well. My 80s, or I think it was an 80s, I can't remember anymore. My Chevy C30 project, the SketchUp model conversion that I was working on, I junked it. It was just being a headache, and I was having so many issues with it that I didn't want to deal with anymore. So just decided to scrap it, and I'm planning to just make my own truck in the future. Some sort of a truck, not that exact same truck necessarily, but a truck in general. Might make my dad's Chevy 6.5 diesel. That's a very nice old truck. But yeah, and then went on Tractor House one day last week and found a whole bunch of good stuff just in the chemical application section. I didn't look through any other section as of yet. So chemical application being sprayers and that kind of stuff. Sprayers, applicators, nurse trailers, fertilizer tenders, all of that good stuff. And found quite a few good things. So I'm going to get started on some of those pretty soon. Not sure which one I'm going to do first, but when I do start on one of those projects, what I'm going to do is do videos the entire, throughout the entire time. Not all of it's going to be commentary, but, like if there's times where I'm going to talk, I'll talk. Other times I'll do set the time, do a high speed video or a time lapse, whatever you want to call it, and add music to it. And then you guys can just kind of see me go from start to finish, doing all of the scripting, doing all of the modeling, all of the texturing, all of that good stuff. And you guys can see that. So when I start that, I'll be doing videos of it. Update on my map. I haven't hardly touched it. To be honest, I've just kind of been taking my time with it. I still have to get down to the farm and take pictures, and then I can kind of go on it, more. But, lately I've just kind of been taking it easy and not really doing much with it. Today, earlier, I did make another field, or two actually, but fields are pretty quick and easy, so I just kind of do one here, do one there, and stuff like that, and that's about all. But, oh, we're out. Not exactly sure where I ran out. It's somewhere on that pass, so we'll go over here and fill up. This and get another screenshot here. Okay, it is refilling good. Go. So yeah, one mod that I'm super happy about that got released is one I've been waiting for a long time. The Brandt Auger, the hitch for it, a working farm king, and then there's also, if we go to Meridian, here we are. There's also a grain bin. This is a new mod from American Eagle's Modding. One that I have been waiting for quite a while. Because I've been watching it as it is being made. Not literally watching, but, seeing video or picture updates of the progress and stuff. And been super excited for that. And so happy that it's finally been released. Just wish that you could put the grain bins onto a map in Giant's Editor, because then I'd have the perfect, you know, bins for my map. But I asked BC Bueller about it, and he mentioned the idea, just, you know, like, if I've known people where they do a Let's Play series, and what they do is take a, you know, like, some equipment from one farm to another, and the way they do that is by editing the save game XML, or the vehicle's XML, I should say, and making it so that they start with that equipment specifically. So I might make the bins to replicate, you know, the real life ones, and then just overlay them on top of the Meridian and do it that way, and then just you know, make them a purchasable thing, but I won't actually purchase them. I will just put, you know, I'll take the physical bin and place it in Giant's Editor, and just to get the coordinates, and then, you know, take my vehicle's XML and edit it so that those bins spawn right where they're supposed to spawn, you know, right where they're supposed to be. And I think that would be really nice. Glad that BC Bueller suggested that, because I'd have never thought of that had he not said that. And when he said that, I was kind of like, oh, that's kind of a good idea, I guess. Never thought of that. So let's see, we'll start right here, I guess. So yeah, American Eagles Modding has had quite a few good releases lately, so that's pretty cool. So I think I'm going to end this video a little early. I have to run and leave the house quick. So yeah, thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe if you enjoyed the videos and to see future videos. Make sure you turn on the post notifications to be notified every time that I post a new video. Video schedule is Tuesdays and Thursdays at 4 p.m. Central Time, and Saturdays at noon Central. Live streams whenever. And don't forget to check out down below in the description for links to all my social medias, mod site, and other cool YouTube channels to check out. I'll see you guys in the next video.